Hey guys, it's me, Cruel, back again with another reaction video on this channel, and today I'll be watching and reacting to Akmu's new song, and I would assume this is considered a comeback, called Happening. And yeah, Lee Soo-hyun just had her solo debut song called Alien a few weeks ago, and it was really cute. I was so happy for her, and I really enjoyed that one, even though it might probably not be my style of song that I would listen to a lot. It was just super satisfying to see her to be like out there, right, have her solo debut, perform, and also very different to see her without her brother. But yeah, they're back already, so I'm super excited for this one. Have not seen any teasers, and let's get right into it. Before we do, quick shout out to my patrons for November. Thanks so much for the continued support, I really appreciate it. And special shout out to 42 Ariadna, Bin, Gaian, and Eldritch. If you guys are also interested in my Patreon for more exclusive content, such as TV show versions like Road to Kingdom, Good Girl Island, Running Man, Show Me the Money, anime and K-drama versions, for example, It's Okay to Not Be Okay, that I'm watching right now, as well as live stage versions, album reviews, and polls for upcoming YouTube videos, then check out my Patreon, link is in the description below. It's also a really good way of supporting me if you want to, which is of course optional, but if you want to, that's the best way, because YouTube, you can don't really help that much, right? You can like a video, comment, and subscribe, that's about it though. But hey, if you're new here, do that as well, right? Subscribe to not miss anything in the future. Upload every single day, and mainly focus on K-pop, sometimes also on K-hip-hop. Also have a Discord server if you want to join that one, link is also in the description. And I will leave a playlist to all my Akmu reactions in the comment section down below, because I've reacted to them before for sure. Not that much yet, because there are still some other songs I had not checked out yet, and I might do in the future, so if you want to see that, request those. And yeah, let's get started with this one. Akmu's Happening. As I said in the beginning, I have not seen any teaser, but I'm ready. I mean, we could kind of expect the style, right? It's either a classical ballad or some kind of pop ballad in a different variation, but more so on the slower side. Ooh, I miss this voice though. Ooh. It's so enchanting, so different. It's deep, but also then again not that deep, you know, if that makes sense. Has been a while since we've seen him. Oh, it's picking up though. Skeletons? That's kind of creepy. Okay, theorizing, right? What does this mean? I would assume the reality is that there's actually people, and he's just seeing them as skeletons, or I guess as dead people. Now, why does he do that? I don't really know. There's like theories I have. There's one that he just ignores everyone, so they're kind of like dead to them, to him, if that makes sense. Like here in Germany, there's like a saying, everyone that I don't care about is just dead to me. Or if someone like annoys you a lot and they like maybe disappoint you trust-wise, you always say they're dead to me. So maybe something like that. Maybe he doesn't trust anyone that is a stranger, and he's looking for someone here for sure, because he's like running through them and like having a goal in mind somewhat. So he's looking for someone, maybe he's looking for Soo-hyun, I'm not sure, but it feels like that he's just either it's dead, that he just doesn't care about them and sees them as dead people, or he has some kind of nightmare, I'm not sure. He doesn't look distressed though. Oh, he found the person. Is it Soo-hyun? It kind of did look like her, huh? Oh, she's so cute, man. And so goddamn pretty. Oh, her voice. I... Don't get me wrong, I kind of liked Alien, but I thought the tempo was very unusual for her voice, right? And this is much more what I love about her, like this tempo here. Like, oh, it's so nice. It's almost, it has this kind of jazz vibe to it, right? Whereas Alien was different. I love her eyes, by the way. She's also one of these people, I think, that smile with their whole face. Or like laugh with their whole face. I love people like that. They always make me happy when they laugh. Like literally anyone that has that. I always get so, like, how do you say it in English? They also make me smile and be happy by doing that. Oh. So she also almost seemed like she fell asleep and then woke up and like everything that she thought was real wasn't real. But she seems much more distressed about this than her brother right now. I don't remember his first name, I'm sorry. But she seems much more distressed about it. Oh, the harmony. Ooh, the harmony. That was so subtle, though, but I love it. Oh, my. Oh, the acoustic guitar break. Dude, it's so good. Oh, my God. Dude, her voice. It's so... so angelic, no, majestic. Her smile is so cute. Oh, it was a skeleton as well. Skeleton. Oh. Wait. Am I reading that right? They have the happy ending, but they deleted the Y and the D for happening. Oh. So. Oh, that's actually cool. Okay, so I guess I have a theory about that, but let's end it first. That's her, though. That was definitely her. I think we saw her face there, too, right? I think it's her. Not sure, though. I think it's her. So it's like happy ending happening. So they, again, just scratched out the Y and the D. So my theory is that... they were talking about in the lyrics about next time we see each other, just ignore me. So they're probably, and he was like looking for her. He was definitely desperately looking for her. He was not really distressed as much as she was. She seemed like she was kind of happy with what she had. Like her, she seemed like she was a bit confused, but then kind of settled with the new reality that she found. And she kind of enjoyed it at the end too. But he for sure was... very desperate about finding her. So out of a story perspective, let's just say it's about the girl and the boy as well here, or I guess the man and the woman. The man in the story seemed pretty like longing for this love. At the same time, he always told himself to, or like was, well, it was more a thought of him, right? But he was wishing for the woman, whenever she sees him, to just ignore him, because I would assume he thinks that he's not good enough for her, for one reason or another. I don't know why. So he is longing for the love, but at the same time thinks he's not good enough. And she probably doesn't even think about him anymore. That's what it seems like. And they're calling it a happening whenever they meet each other. So it's just kind of like randomly happening, so to speak. It's just a meeting, a fateful or not fateful meeting. But it's not really, comparing happy ending to happening, right? Happy ending is something probably that the guy wants here, but at the same time he tells her in his thoughts to just let it be a happening, you know? If we meet each other, it happened, but let's just ignore it and, you know, just move on. So something like that is kind of like, I don't know, kind of not contradicting, but it's kind of talking about not the difference. Also, how do I say that in English? Jesus Christ, my vocabulary right now. It's kind of the parallelism between both the happening and the happy ending. But this, I don't know. That's my best guess right now. I'm not 100% sure. So, reading the commentator, doing the whole MV, Chan-hyuk, oh, that's the guy's name, sorry, is restless while Soo-hyun seems sad but doesn't move around much and tries to appreciate the world around her. Yes, Chan-hyuk isn't over the breakup, still in denial, looking for his lover, yes. While Soo-hyun has already given up the relationship, trying to heal but feeling guilty for her lover, who's teary-eyed and still has deep feelings for her. She still loves him as well, but has accepted the reality. There's no point in trying to revive what is over, while Chan-hyuk is still running after the skeleton of his lover and hurting himself, hugging cactus while doing so. Yeah, that's kind of what I thought, right? They have very different viewpoints about the past relationship. And the guy at the same time, Chan-hyuk here, I guess, even though he's still longing for her and the love and the relationship, at the same time, I think that's like his daydream. At the same time, he's being realistic though in his thought process, saying, whenever you meet me, I hope you just move on, you ignore me. I hope you ignore me and are happy. Because he probably is not confident in himself to make her happy. That's what I think. So it's a very sad, like a very, very sad and almost depressing viewpoint out of his perspective. But yeah, anyways, that's the story. As for the song, it's a very slow song. It's not the classical ballad. It's somewhat like of a slow pop ballad. It's just super, super nice. It's literally what I love ACMU for. But it's a little bit more upbeat and a little bit more funky, so to speak, than, for example, the Heartbreak song, with like this really long title, If You Love Heartbreak. I don't remember the whole title, I never really remembered the title on purpose. But yeah, that long song. That was actually also my first ACMU song, and I think it came out last year, right? After a long year hiatus. But yeah, that's about it from this video. I really like the song. I was so, so happy with both the voices. That one harmony in the middle was so good, dude. Like, I don't know, vocally you cannot say anything bad about this at all. The song was also pretty cool. Again, the funky element to it was something I did not expect from them, but I was super happy to see it because it added the flavor that it kind of makes it more complete and gave it a really cool new perspective, or like my perspective of ACMU songs really changed with this one. So I was super, super happy to hear this, and yep, this is absolutely my favorite ACMU song, I'm pretty sure. I would say the If You Love Heartbreak kind of song was more emotional and much more depressing and melodramatic. So if you really want to listen to a song like that and you want to indulge yourself in that emotion, then I guess the other song is better. But overall, this one here is much more my type of tea. Usually, you know, the other one is something that I cannot listen to every day. This I probably could. So that's why I prefer this one a bit. And I really liked it. Let me know your opinion in the comments as well, of course. And if you like my reaction, leave a like, subscribe if you haven't yet. And peace.